Hey girl, welcome to Overcoming Narcissistic Relationships with Olivia. I am so happy that you're here and listening to this right now because I have a bucket load of questions for you. The first one is, are you currently in or have you previously been in a toxic relationship before? Have you wasted valuable time and energy hoping that he would change? Do you keep attracting men that aren't good for you or falling for the wrong men? Have you been wondering if you're unhappy and deserve better than what you've been getting? Have you discovered that your partner or your ex-partner is a narcissist or has traits of a narcissist? Are you recovering from narcissistic abuse? Are you wondering how to overcome these relationships and break the cycle of going back to toxic love and toxic men? If you answered yes to any of these, then you are in the right place. This is a feel-good podcast for the woman on her journey to self-love, confidence, and worthiness. Each episode, I will bring to you an inspiring guest or an empowering thought that will help you bust through your fears, connect to your soul, and get clear so that you can elevate yourself in your life and your relationships. Get ready for some real talk and to unapologetically take charge and reclaim the life and relationships that you really want. My name is Olivia and I'm a relationship and narcissist recovery coach. Bringing women together to create positive change within themselves and others is what I do. Are you with me? Here we go. Hello, ladies. So I just want to say that I know it can feel really, really tough when you're going through what you're going through, okay? And I think a lot of the time we actually wonder, oh my God, am I actually going to be okay? Am I going to make it through this? Am I ever going to feel happy again? Am I ever going to feel better again? Am I ever going to love life again? Am I ever going to smile and laugh again? And actually that reminds me of, for the Sex and the City fans, I really love Charlotte. And I remember on the first movie, Carrie, where Mr. Big basically doesn't show up for their wedding day and kind of leaves her in the lurch and all this sort of stuff. I remember she said to them, like, she was super depressed, of course, because she's been on and off with this guy for 10 whole years, like a really, really, really long time. It's like a whole decade. It's a massive part of someone's life. And so I remember she actually asked her friend, she's like, you know, well, firstly, she's like, draw the curtains. I don't want to go out, because she ended up going on a honeymoon. And she's like, draw the curtains. And she was super depressed. And she just wanted to basically run away. And she just internalized everything. And she just fell into the fetal position. And she just wasn't coping, obviously, because she was going through massive betrayal and disappointment and everything like that. And she actually said to them, she's like, am I ever going to smile again? And it was really sad because I remember feeling like that. I remember thinking, am I ever going to be happy again? Am I always going to feel this way? Am I ever going to be okay or even better than okay? Because you have to understand, my whole financial well-being was hanging in the wings, you know, and I'd attached myself to this man so much that I'd lost myself. I'd lost myself in the relationship. I'd lost my own sense of identity. I'd lost my self-trust. I, you know, questioned my own sanity. I was like, am I even thinking the right things? Did this actually even happen? You know, like, he had a way of turning things around and made me think, oh my gosh, maybe my memory is flawed or I failed to think the right way. I remember there'd been multiple times where I sat there and, like, after the breakup, I had to take a couple of weeks off work. Like, I just wasn't functioning. Like, yeah, I couldn't do normal activity living, like daily stuff, like even talking to family and friends. I actually couldn't concentrate on a conversation. I was constantly burping because of my irritable bowel syndrome. Like literally, I struggled to sleep. I didn't even eat properly. You know, I was really struggling. And there were multiple times that I thought, am I going to be all right? Am I going to be okay? I don't know if I'm going to be all right, you know, and I made it through. And that's the thing I want you guys to know. That even though you're probably wondering, am I going to be okay? You are. You have a lot of time left on this earth and you are going to make it through. There are phases through our lives that we endure and we go through. Some of them are more pleasant than others. Some of them are more unpleasant than others, and I can tell you which ones they are. And so if you're doubting and you're wondering, I'm here to reassure you that you will be all right. You know, as long as you seek help, you invest in yourself and you look after yourself, everything will turn out the way it's meant to. You know, you're going through this experience for a reason, even though you may not know what that is. Yeah. You're going to be learning lessons that you've probably never learned before and things that you'll never forget. And it's going to set you on the path that you're meant to be on. And this is part of alignment. Like, everyone I've ever spoken to that's been through a toxic or narcissistic relationship has come out the other side and have learned what they needed to learn. So even though you may not see the light at the end of the tunnel, you may not know what the meaning this situation is supposed to be providing you right now, you will figure it out eventually. And don't put pressure on yourself. Just kind of let it be. Just let it come. it'll make itself clearer with time. You know, like sometimes we go through things in life where we're like, why is this happening to me? I've done all the right things. And why have I got to be the one that's, you know, like I had a recent client that signed up with me. She's 32 and her marriage broke down after nearly a decade. And she's like, this wasn't supposed to happen to me. This wasn't part of my life plan. And here I am getting divorced and all my friends are settling down, having children and getting married. Like I've got to start all over again and has wasted all this time of my life. And of course I coached her through that, all those limiting beliefs and that sort of thing. And so I just want you guys to know that, yeah, you're going to be all right. You're going to be okay. Just keep showing up for yourself in whatever capacity that looks like, whether that be, you know, you read books and you love yourself through that, or you give yourself baths, or you say no to people, or even just make it through the day. Like that's an achievement for some people when they're going through something like this. You know, you made it through the day, you're still alive, you're still breathing, you're still eating, you still have a job, you still have a house, you know, or at least shelter over you. You know, you're not freezing to death on the streets in a box, you know, so I just wanted to give that reassurance. So if you're currently with someone that you're not happy with and you know that something's not quite right, you know that something's wrong, you're feeling stuck, you don't know where to turn to, you're feeling like your health is suffering, you're feeling like it's taking up all this mental space, you know, thinking about this man, whether you're married or whether you're in a relationship with him or if he's your baby daddy, you know, you're thinking and you're trying to problem solve and you're mulling the thoughts over and you're going round and round and round and round and it's exhausting you. Yeah. So that's okay. Like it's meant to happen that way. But the most important thing is self-care and just having that undying faith and belief that, you know, you've made it this far through life. I'm sure you've been through other adversities. And if you've made it through that, you can make it through this. And so this is something that I'll be touching on in my online program that I'm running in October. And I don't want you guys to think that I'm just sitting here and trying to sell to you, because I don't even consider myself a salesperson. I find them icky and sleazy and a bit gross and a bit, I don't know, self-interested maybe. They're in it for their own self-gain, like especially like real estate agents and car salespeople and all that sort of stuff. Like it just doesn't sit well with me. So if you're anything like me, you'll understand what I'm saying. But I'm running this 6-week introductory course and I'm running it for you guys. Yeah. So I'll be showing up every week for 1 hour on a Facebook Live. We might go over. We'll see how we go. It depends how it's all going. And I know a lot of you guys have been messaging me and asking me more about it and showing a lot of interest. But, you know, there comes a time where you've just got to take a leap. And you've just got to trust that everything will be okay. And that by doing little things like this, it's investing in your future. It's investing in your healing and your recovery. I am here for you. You are not alone in this. Okay. Like I will be showing up. I will be answering your questions. I will be guiding you through the process and shining a light on the path ahead while you're making your way through this process. Yeah. So I just want you guys to know that if you're feeling alone, if you're feeling unsupported and you're needing more nurturing and you're needing more personable care than just my podcast, because my podcast is great, but it's not necessarily dealing with you specifically. Do you know what I mean? Like, yes, okay, toxic and narcissistic relationships and it's my baby and I love it. But, you know, Sally that's sitting here and listening to this, she's got her own set of issues and set of limiting beliefs and her own confusions and all this sort of stuff going on that, you know, I can't really provide that one-to-one care, I suppose, like I would if I was coaching someone. And so that's why I've created this program, basically. Like, I know that the podcast is great and it's working for a lot of people and I get messages all the time about it, which is, I love it. It's phenomenal. But for real change to happen, you've got to be active. You can't just be passive. Like, anyone can sit there and listen to a podcast. It's not hard. You know, you listen to it as you're doing housework. You listen to it on the way to work. You listen to it when you're in the bath, like whatever it is, when you walk the dog, if you're a dog person. We all know I'm a cat person, but you know, like it's somewhat passive, you know, because even though you're showing up and you're listening to it, it's an easy thing to do. And so when you've reached a point where you're like, okay, that served me, but I still know I've got some healing to do and I still know there's more that I need to be doing, that's when you really need to get someone on your side to help you specifically get through the issues that you're personally facing. And you all know that on a gut level, like everybody knows on an intuitive level if there's still more to go. Yeah, like you might be like, oh, I've done about 50% and, you know, I'm not in dire straits anymore. I think I'm doing all right. I'm functioning. I'm still going to work and, you know, I'm dipping my toes in the dating scene and most of the stuff is wrapped up with my ex and all this sort of stuff. You're about 50% of the way. There is still more to go and I'm here to show you the way. So if you are interested, and I know a lot of you are, send me a message. Let's get this happening. Let's get you into the group and secure you a spot. And so once you've made that decision, you know that you have got 6 hours plus with me, someone that's already gone through this process to help you. Yeah. You know that you've finally decided to commit to yourself and take this leap. And so that's why I take deposits, guys, to secure that position, to get it happening so you've finally made the decision rather than sitting there and swaying back and forth and wondering and blah, blah. Like, you actually know, okay, yep, I've made this decision. I know it's going to be worth it, even though I'm not sure what it's going to involve entirely, but I'm willing to give it a go. I'm willing to set myself up for success. I'm willing to feel better before Christmas. You know, I'm willing to learn the tools and the models and the skills that I need as an adult to run my life more effectively and run my relationships more effectively. Yeah. So if you think that this is you that I'm speaking to, and as I said, I'm just sharing this, I'm not here to sell you anything. If it's not for you and you're not ready for it, that is okay too. I'm here to let you know that it's okay. If you're not ready yet, I don't want you in the group. Yeah. If you're not ready to like open your mind and consider some different things and help yourself, that's all right. You can stay in this group. I'm not here just to make money. I'm not here just to be like, yep, pay me and I'll take your money and I'll tell you a few things. I'm actually here to show up for the people that really want to transform their mindset and change the trajectory of their lives. You know, it's funny being a business owner now, I've worked with quite a few people and I know that as a business owner, I really only want to work with the people that are willing to show up for themselves. You know, it's far too much work trying to get people on board when they aren't ready and they're not willing. It's not worth the time and the energy because they haven't done a certain amount of recovery yet. And so, you know, no matter where you're at, I'm not going to say no to you. Like, the bare minimum is that you turn up for yourself. You're turning up for you. That's the thing. You're investing in yourself. You know, like, that's what it's all about, really. That's the whole point of doing a course like this. This is the whole point of even being in coaching, is to help other people. It's not just to help yourself. You know, if I was here just to help myself, I'd be doing something else, you know? So yeah, I trust that you guys understand that. And I trust that, you know, you believe me when I say that. So I just want you to know that as well. It's going to be a very personable experience. So I do expect, you know, the members to interact, you know, to their level of comfortability, of course. And so you're going to have me one-to-one, well, not one-to-one, but close enough one-to-one with a group of other people to ask those pressing questions and to work through that stuff on the spot. So I thought I'd throw that out there. So once again, if you're not feeling okay, I want you to know that one day you will be, because I've been there before. I've wondered whether I'll be okay or not. I've wondered if I'd end up with mental health illnesses and never find love again and never be happy again. And you know what? Like, I may not have found love just yet, but I've found love internally and my whole life has transformed and I've never been happier. And so if you want that for yourself and like learn to be really happy single, or level up in your relationship and get it back on track again, or maybe wonder about, maybe you're thinking, maybe I don't want to be in this relationship, maybe I want to get out, that's cool too. That's fine. Everybody's in a different place. So that's all I wanted to share with you guys, and I'll talk to you soon. Have a great one. Thank you for listening, sister friends. For more support and one-on-one coaching to help you through your own recovery journey, or if you're wanting to start a business in this niche, then you can email me at oliviapowellcoaching@gmail.com. That's oliviapowellcoaching@gmail.com. To connect with other like-minded women who might be in the same stiletto heels as you right now, head to my online virtual space on Facebook by searching Overcoming Narcissistic Relationships with Olivia. Just answer the entry questions and feel free to invite your girlfriends. Or come and hang out with me on YouTube or Instagram, where you will find pretty pictures, uplifting and thought-provoking quotes, and tons of value that you don't want to miss. If you enjoyed this episode or something has resonated with you, then be sure to subscribe to this podcast so that you're informed of every single episode that comes out and so you don't miss a thing. Share the love by passing this on to someone that you know who would benefit from hearing the free content of this podcast. And I would really appreciate it if you would leave a review on iTunes, because your review will help the success of this show so that it has the potential to reach many more women who would benefit from hearing this message too. For more beyond this podcast and places to reach me, please see the show notes for all the links. Until next time, much love, Olivia.